Trains for sale. It's not something you see too often. But with the new Waratah carriages now being slowly rolled out, 500 of the old silver rattlers are on the market. Already there's been interest from foreign rail operators, scrap metal dealers, and even mums and dads who want one for the backyard.
40 years after the first silver sets hit the rails, the state government is about to start pensioning them off. Offers to purchase 550 carriages are being assessed. RailCorp says the trains have got a lot of life left in them.
These silver sets have carried millions of people over the years, and every now and then they might have a door problem or something small in nature occur to them.
Door problems plague these trains, along with a lack of air conditioning and heating.
They're filthy, dirty, graffiti covered, and I was only thinking that on the way to work yesterday. It's not a pleasant experience.
I reckon they're no good because, you know, I paid to catch a train and I'm standing up, sweating. You know, I'm waiting for these new trains to come out.
They're always overcrowded, so I can't wait till I get rid of them.
They're crappy, but I do catch them.
It's expected some will end up as granny flats and sheds, others taken up by overseas rail operators and heritage groups. Just how quickly these old trains are withdrawn from service depends on the delivery of the new Waratah trains, which are already running 4 years late. Five Waratahs are in service, but there's controversy over taxpayers being slugged an extra $175 million to pay for them.
Our concern is whether or not corners have been cut for reliability and for safety testing to get these trains on the rails.
The difficulty with this contract is that there are many moving parts. There is a long time to run, and you can't rule anything in or out.
John Hill, 10 News.